What is good, YouTube? I'm back at it again with another video, and if you're new here, hi, my name is I'm Isabel. If you're not, welcome back to the channel. As you guys can tell by the title, I'm going to be traveling 6 hours to go see Drake. And I'm not gonna lie, if you guys don't know the backstory, I'm gonna tell you guys the backstory right now, okay? So it was like, I think it was a Saturday. Like at the beginning of February. I don't know what Saturday it was. Was it a Saturday? Honestly, I don't even know. Basically, I was at work and my coworker Dolly, she was like, how she really wants to go to a Drake concert. And me being impulsive, I was like, let's go. And she was like, let's go. And then we told our, like, my other coworker, D, like, come on, let's go. And she was like, let's go. And fast forward, we're going in, like, less than, like, a day. Which is so crazy to me. I love impulsive things. I love to do impulsive things. But I'm not gonna lie, I don't know if you guys could tell, I'm literally so tired. This side of my face, like, literally, like, this right here, I have a major headache right now. It's like pounding. And I've been trying to pack for the longest, and I have not even started packing yet. And you guys are probably wondering, like, Emma, like, what do you have to pack? It's just a concert. I have to pack my whole life. That is the only way that I'm surviving. So I'm gonna pack an extra outfit or two just in case I don't like the outfit that I initially planned to go with and everything. So yeah, I'm going to try and pack today, like tonight, but if I don't, then I'm gonna have to wake up early in the morning tomorrow and pack. And then I also have to go and get an oil change. I also have to go and get gas. It's just so much. So let's go. Like, come along with me, guys.
The next day.
Good morning, guys. I'm about to start packing right now because I am running a little bit late. So come along with me.
Puma hanging on my neck. The bracelet matches a set. My brother's name is Tina Dollar. Stop all that back and forth over the net.
Guys, I'm all settled in. I don't know if I probably put in the TikTok. Did you guys see how much I packed for this trip? This one day trip? It's only because I don't know what I want to wear. And then I brought my rollers for my hair and everything like that because, you know, my hair is very, like, flat right now and everything. So, yeah. Oh, I didn't even tell you guys, Oscar's here as well.
I'm just an accessory.
He's not just an accessory. Oscar's actually gonna go on his own adventure today. I might come with him as well. I'm not sure yet, but we're gonna be in Buffalo, so we're gonna be at the, like, literally the border for Canada, so why not go and get some snack wraps, you know what I mean?
I'm just an accessory for this trip.
Babe, why are you saying it like that?
I'm not going to the concert, guys. I'm just a driver. I'm a personal driver.
Oh, we're on our way to go pick up D right now. D, if you're watching this, I told you 9:30 to 10 a.m. It is currently 10:50, okay?
Can we put a timer, like, once we get there? So that, like, you put a timer on the thing?
Okay,
see how long D.
I'll
D, yo, I'm not gonna lie, D, we on your ass. You really, yo, we about to put you on the spot.
Okay, so I'm gonna put a timer on once we get to her house. And then we're gonna see how long it takes her to come down, okay? All right. Hey guys, setting the timer right now. I'm gonna give it the benefit of the doubt. Put the stopwatch on.
Timer started.
All right, let me tell her that we're here. All right, let's see how long it takes her to come. Let's see how long it takes her.
A few moments later.
All right guys, so she actually came up really early.
Now we look like assholes. Oh. Now everyone's like, damn, these are just dickheads. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay, so it's 4 minutes and 52 seconds.
Hi.
Hey, D. Say hi to the vlog.
Hey, vlog.
I'm not gonna lie. I'm gonna be real honest with you. We were timing you.
You were?
Yeah.
Okay, how long did I take?
5 minutes.
Yeah. I tell the camera now, we look like assholes.
I wish I would've went corporate, she wish I would've went exec. I still turn to a CEO, so the lifestyle she respect. Hey, 2 sprinters to Quebec, Chevy, Uwe, Montbeck. They only giving niggas.
Guys, it's so fucking floggy. I was gonna say vloggy, it's so foggy right now. Like, you piss
off
so much.
Yeah,
honestly. Ah! Because we're in the mountains.
Hey, she want me to play with that cat. She love how I make it on wet. Hey, you know how sticky it get. Hey, hey, yo, Eric, bring them girls to the stage, cause somebody's getting paid. Passion it from miles away. Passing for the things you say. Passing up on my always. I can't blame you now. Getting paid and free big slime out the cage. Shorty try to play it cool, but now she wish you would've stayed. Cause
okay, I started.
Dumbbell.
I'm not gonna lie, we just stopped and I think we have like an hour and a half left, right? So I'm gonna start driving. So there are hot and spicy McChickens up here, so that's what I've been waiting for, to eat a hot and spicy McChicken. And Edwin, I know you're jealous right now, but it's okay. I'll bring you one. I was going to say that I was gonna bring you back one, but okay, I guess.
I got you, don't worry. You know I got you. Bro. All
right, guys, so we're at McDonald's. The only reason why I'm recording, like, you know, cause we're not in our hometown.
If we died, we died in Danville, you heard?
All I'm here for, hot and spicy McChicken. Too. Are you getting anything to eat?
Yeah.
What?
Large fries, that's it.
Just a large fries?
Yeah, I'm gonna get a bacon king.
Oh, okay. All right, guys, I got the hot and spicy McChicken. So let's try it and rate it 1 to 10. I'm sorry.
Stare at her.
No, don't stare. It makes her uncomfortable. Exactly.
No, exactly, do it.
No.
I was staring at her already.
So the last time I had a hot and spicy McChicken, Edwin ate it through the wrapper. Stop!
Wait, what do you mean he ate it through the wrapper? Oh, sorry, you're not talking
about this. Oh no, you can talk. Like, look, like the wrapper was on like this, and like he like he was hungry.
Why did he do that?
He likes it.
I don't know.
Edwin is hilarious. It's good.
Mm-hmm.
I'll take your
word for it. Sally, it's not that spicy.
Okay. It looks mad thin.
It's not that spicy. It's better than a regular McChicken.
Nah, his shit looks thin. I don't know what the fuck he's eating, but bro. Oh, he got 3 of them.
Cheeseburger.
What the hell?
He fucking that shit up, too.
Kill him, Patty.
Alright guys, so first thing about this house, it doesn't really look that stable because this lock kind of looks a little crazy, but once you walk in, you get to this little den place right here, which is so nice, so cute, comfortable. And then you get over here, this is like the little kitchen right here.
Kitchen?
Oh, the little, I don't know what this is called. But
table?
This table, right? These were actually up, but we put them down because we don't want anyone in our business. So this is a desk right here, and they left us some nice pens, which is very nice. What is that? I don't know, but cool. You come over here.
Fireplace?
Yes, to the fireplace. This mirror that I have a feeling is a video thingy.
Like Saw?
Yeah, like Saw. So yes, we come over here. Oh, is that the Wi-Fi?
It is.
Hmm. The Wi-Fi to the password.
The Wi-Fi to the password.
Bro, that door opened and it's mad creepy.
What do you mean?
Yeah, it's just stairs. Like stairs.
Stairs going down or up?
Both.
The Conjuring?
No.
Oh, okay, so this is the little living room area right here, and they left us some nice Uno cards and chess, which is very nice. This is like a little, what is this shit called?
I don't know.
You like sit and like, you know, yeah. This is the TV right here where Oscar will be playing his PlayStation from.
Facts.
This is room number one.
We're walking inside.
It's not really that bad, but like this is room number one.
We're just walking
here. Not that bad. And then we come over here, and this is the kitchen. Very nice kitchen, if I do say so myself. Very nice, very nice. Then you come over here, and this is like a little area where you can like dine or whatever. All the cups and everything like here.
BBC.
Okay. This is me and Oscar's room. Very nice, very nice. We took the one with the desk because I need to record my get ready with me and, you know, all that good stuff for you guys. And then we come over here. This is D'Angelise's room.
D'Angelise?
Just put out her old government for you guys. So, and then
just call me D, guys.
And here's the bathroom.
There's a tub.
It's okay. It's like
old.
Very old, but yeah. That is it for Emma's MTV Buffalo edition. Get ready with me to go to a Drake concert in Buffalo. I'm in Buffalo right now. If you know me, I'm from the Bronx. I'm literally 6 hours away from home. It was a very impulsive decision, but we're here. I have all my makeup products, but I just don't have a mirror, so I'm going to be using my phone. So hopefully my makeup comes out good. I also don't have music because Oscar's not here right now. And I was gonna use his phone, but yeah, we're just gonna vibe to my voice, I guess. My face has been breaking out again. Like, look, there's a pimple right here. I don't know what's going on. I think it might be because I'm starting like a new skincare routine and everything like that. But like, honestly, I don't know because this never happens to me. So I don't know what's going on. I'm actually regretting not bringing my laptop because I could edit and everything like that, and I could also play music, so I lost there, I guess you can say. I put on a little bit more lighting so that I could see a little bit more, but I'm kind of excited. I did go to the first Drake concert and it was okay, so hopefully this one is okay as well. But right now it's currently 7:21. The concert apparently starts at 8. So I have like 30 minutes to get ready. I'm not gonna lie, this pimple right here is gonna be the death of me. Because I don't think I could cover that up whatsoever. But I'm here in Buffalo with my coworkers. Because this was a very impulsive decision. You guys can see more of this little trip though, by the way, on my YouTube. Because I'm going to be posting it on YouTube. Actually struggling right now because I usually have a mirror in front of me and I don't know if my phone is just like gonna do it because I can obviously see myself through my phone, but like I can't really see everything that I need to see, you know what I mean? Also guys, they have hot and spicy McChickens out here. Like, I know I sound like a fat ass, but they deadass have hot and spicy McChickens out here, and I tried it and it's so good. The last time I was up here, I had a hot and spicy McChicken. I don't know why they don't have it in the Bronx, to be honest with you. They should bring it back in the Bronx. I went to go look into the mirror. I feel like my makeup looks so bad, and my makeup never looks bad. So, kind of panicking right now because I feel like it looks really bad. I've learned this trick, by the way, guys, that putting like powder foundation on after like your concealer and everything sets everything in. Like, look at how much better this side looks than this side. Do you guys see the difference? I don't know if you guys see the difference. Okay, see, look, you guys could definitely see the difference now. Like, you could see, like, how it's, like, you don't see the line. I know y'all see it. I know y'all see it. My line is gone. But yeah, this is my holy grail, and it's by Sephora. and it's in the shade 44 Natural Almond. Did bring my palette with me this time, so I think I'm going to try and make it like a little bit. I'm gonna go in with these two right here. No, this one and this one, these two. So like, do you guys see the difference? Like, you see how this one is more like cooled down, and this one is like, you can obviously tell like I did not give a fuck. Yeah, basically. Obviously, you guys can see that my face looks dull, and that's because I don't have any blush on my face. So we're obviously gonna go in with my holy grail, the Charlotte Tilbury blush, cheek to cheek. Okay, like, come on, like, you obviously can't, like, you could tell the difference that like this side is more like alive, and then this side is like dead. Alive, dead, like, come on. I'm so sorry, guys, that I don't have any music playing. I know I'm really boring, but please bear with me today. Okay, now on to lips. We are going in with my MAC lip pencil in the shade Plum. I'm stuck in between my Maracuja and my MAC lip gloss, so I'm gonna see how this one looks. If I don't like it, I'm gonna take it off, and obviously I'm gonna put it on my Maracuja, so let's see. It's really a nice, pretty color. Ooh, hold on. I don't know, guys. She like low-key eats. I think I'm gonna keep it like this. So yeah, that's my makeup. Let me put on some setting spray, and then I'm gonna see you guys in part two when I get dressed, because I obviously don't know what I'm wearing yet, because I brought multiple outfits, okay? So we're gonna figure it out soon. Get ready with me to go to a Drake concert part two. So guys, I just finished my makeup. Oh, that didn't even spray in my face. And I have to pick out an outfit. I don't know what I want to wear yet, because like, I'm stuck. I have two outfits, well, technically three outfits, so I don't know what I want to wear. Let's figure it out together. I'm really loving this makeup, and I did it without a mirror. I'm obsessed. Like, look, except for this pimple. Don't look at this pimple, but like, I bodied. All right, guys, so I have multiple outfits, okay? So this is gonna be like the first outfit, right? So this is like the top. Yeah, this is the top. But then I have this top with either these jeans or this leather skirt. But it's kind of brick, so I think I might go with the jeans. But then I also have this other outfit. Let me show you guys. And I had originally bought this outfit for it, but like, I don't know, the pants are kind of really tight. They're not like elastic, but this is the top, and it's actually a really cute bottom. But yeah, let me put this on and I'm gonna show you guys first. All right, so look, these are the pants, and they're really nice. Like, they're really nice, but it's just too tight up here, and I just can't deal with that. So let me try on the next outfit for you guys. Alright, so these are the second pants, and I honestly think I'm gonna go with these pants instead, because they're way more comfortable. But I just realized that I can't put my top on until I take off my hair, so let me take out my hair. Alright, first one review. Yeah. The only thing that I'm missing though is my hairspray, which I forgot. And I knew I was forgetting something. I forgot multiple things on this trip, and I felt like I brought the whole world with me. Obviously, I didn't. You guys already know, last to reveal. These don't look that bad, but I feel like that they're gonna loosen up because I don't have the hairspray. So. Okay, let me shake it out. Okay, just shook it out. Oh yeah, she's definitely giving. All right, guys, so this is the outfit, and I do say that I love it. See you guys in my vlog. Bye. All right, guys, I'm getting ready right now, and all I gotta do is put on my shoes, to be honest, and I'm ready. So that's what we're gonna do right now. I'm gonna try to put on my shoes.
These are the shoes, by the way.
A few moments later.
Alright guys, so I'm ready and we're about to head out soon. As you guys can see the fit. I'm loving the fit, but I forgot my sunglasses. Another thing added to the list that I forgot. But yeah, let's go.
You know how sticky it get, ayy. You know how sticky it get, ayy. You know how sticky it get, ayy. She want me to play with that cat, ayy. She love how I'm making her wet, ayy. You know how sticky it get, ayy. Just like a Jamie Beach, I wanna get back to the days that you love me for nothing but what you could see. Everybody that came out here from back home, you know how much I love you, you know how much I love our city. It's nothing like it. So cheers to Buffalo tonight. We want to treat Buffalo like the six tonight. Cheers to Buffalo. We love y'all for real.
Yeah.
me. Write my name, remember your list. I'm taking it twice, and I'm getting the name. Real's been dying, the friends are lit. Papers on ballots, I'm back on my shit. Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty. My dust on like it, you all about that. She was in my man club, long hair, brown skin. Sat beside me, used to laugh, had mad joke. The teacher always got mad, so she passed note. And started off so innocent. She had a vibe and a nigga started digging it up. She caught me up all night, hey. She got me up. The bad news is, nigga, you went the wrong way. Think being broke was better.
But the beats are made to sweat. Who might never mind speak? I put it single for my name. Life checking and shit. I signed for a couple million. You only touch a 100,000.
Oh my god! The lights came back and they actually won! They actually did it! Aubrey Graham, Jermaine Cole, with a stellar all-star performance tonight. What you guys have just witnessed is the greatest night in sports history.
Hi guys, so I'm not gonna lie, I didn't record because my phone literally died, but came home, you know, concert was good and everything like that. I will be doing my review in the morning of the concert though, because I am really tired and I'm gonna go to bed. Oscar's already tucked in, nighty night. I'm gonna go to bed and I'll see you guys in the morning.
Alright guys, just left the house. I didn't record because me, Dolly, and Oscar were playing Phase 10. So, we're going to Burger King and McDonald's right now. And then I will give you my review once we get there.
Alright Edwin, we got your 11.
10.
10, I mean 10s. Hot and spicy McChickens in here, okay?
Big boy.
They're all in here.
Yo, Eric, bring them girls to the stage, cause somebody's getting paid, and free big slime out the cage, and shorty tried to play it cool, but now she wish she would've stayed, cause every song that I made is ringing like I got engaged. I love my guys, I wouldn't trade, ay, from the cradle to the grave, ay, Gordo got me on a wave, and got me on a...
Hey guys, I'm back home, and I'm gonna do my little review and wrap this video up because it is a long video. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys stayed to the end. If you're still here, please comment down your favorite Drake song that you've listened to. So that I know the real ones that are like, you know, that stayed from beginning to end. But yeah, I enjoyed the concert. I feel like I still have the same review as I did as the first concert. J. Cole was also nice as well. He's a good performer, guys. He is a good performer. But I feel like if you guys watch my first Drake vlog, like the first concert I went to with I have the same reaction, same thing, except this time we didn't stand for hours. This time, like, I literally got there, I think, at like 9 o'clock, and then, like, the thing started at 9:30, so it really wasn't that bad. So, yeah. Overall, guys, I give the concert a 9 out of 10, and would I definitely do it again? Probably. Most likely I would. I did enjoy it. I enjoyed the people that I went with as well. And yeah, so that is the end of the vlog, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed. I enjoyed making this vlog for you guys. I love you guys. And of course, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.